Till we meet again. This axe just keeps getting stronger. I am, as always, at your service. What can I make for you? Hey, what happened to all the armor we made you already?
I used it.
Well, maybe try to make this one last longer.
I will not.
I'll disinfect my tools. You've been quite the archaeologist, haven't you? Be safe! Another of Cavassier's poems. Best of luck.
Any outsider is considered a threat. Is that to protect the dwarves?
It sounds like it. But knowing Odin, there's sure to be an ulterior motive.
Well, everyone's hiding on this side too.
Odin's occupation of this realm has its hooks in deep.
But there aren't any guards patrolling. We're clearly not a threat. Why hide?
Resist and you're made an example of, to keep the rest in line. Self-preservation can outweigh bravery for even the strongest of folk.
Fear keeps them safe and alive.
Tavern's gotta be around here somewhere. Maybe we can try knocking on some doors for directions. Could you maybe...
No! Thank you!
A firebomb from the chief anti-Odin propagandist in Durland's rebellion. Quite a sharp wit she had until she turned to a subtle means of resistance.
Behind you, brother!
I think we need some special equipment to use this. think I see something. Excuse me, but we're looking for...
Nothing for you here. I don't care what you want. No food, no encouraging words, no nothing. Leave!
I think we need some special equipment to use this. This looks promising, right? Well, it's like a house. If he's here, maybe you should let me do the talking.
You?
Well, we don't want to intimidate him. You're tall as a tree and you have a severed head on your head.
None taken. Fair point, though.
Very well.
That's him. Hello?
Watch yourselves. Apparently, there are intruders about.
Oh, that's us, I think.
Well, if you're planning on killing me, at least let me finish this song. That alarm was in just the perfect key.
We're just looking for a friend of ours named Derlin.
Well, we both know that's not true. Derlin's got no friends left. But if that's all you need, head out the back way there, and you'll see the safety office just across the river. Just don't go making trouble for the rest of us. And while you travel through this realm, maybe you could clean up the head's mess?
What mess?
Later, brother.
I wish to hear of this mess.
The rig's in the bay. Why don't you ask the condescending skull?
Head, I've got skin. But he's right. I made a mistake. I'd have us shut them down.
sorry, one more thing. Although, these are gifts I'm giving to you, so I shouldn't be sorry and you should be thankful. Anyways, here, please be careful.
It's beautiful. Thanks, Sindri.
It is beautiful, isn't it? It's also very useful. You'll be able to find anything your heart desires with it.
Really?
As long as your heart desires the locations your father and you decide and plot to travel together, then yes.
It is a compass.
Ah, but a beautiful compass. Now scamper off.
Boat cannot be far.
Huh. Earlier, Sindri made it sound like Durlan was some sort of rebellion leader. Doesn't sound like anyone's following him.
Was being the key word here, little brother.
I saw a dock back there. Maybe there's a boat we can use to get to Durlan's. There's a building just past these rocks behind me. Maybe we should head that way.
Ugh, those bloody mining rigs.
What about them?
The Skald is right to blame me for them. They were my idea. If you've got the time, they're in the bay just beyond this tunnel.
I'd particularly appreciate us checking out the mining rigs in the lake to the right. You can see the smokestacks from here.
But if you don't want to explore now, it looks like Durlan's place is through that open gate to the left. So, which way do we go? We could prepare more before rescuing Tyr. Up to you. Mimir, were you really the one who had those rigs built?
Odin wanted the dwarves under his control, and, well, I convinced him he could buy their allegiance instead of demanding it outright. A trade agreement of sorts.
Father, is it always moral to kill something that's trying to kill you?
Yes.
Well, there you have it, lad.
Now that's a big statue. Dragon sculpture is not bad.
not the first time someone's told me that, I suppose.
I think I see something.
Atreus. You are getting better. Faster.
I'd even be better than you one day, huh?
If you are not, I have failed.
Oh.
Taking a break before visiting Durlan? Very wise. He can be a lot.
Thanks for grabbing this.
At your service. By the way, if you're headed to the mining rigs in the bay, could you bring me any slag you find? I could use the material for my crafting.
Frogger holes. We've got to clear out all these undead bastards.
That!
You're on fire, Kratos. It will pass.
Yeah.
No. It's still here.
What?
The island near the geyser. We need to get the key from it and unlock this door. I need to set right a very old wrong.
What's behind the door?
A prisoner of sorts.
You've got some relics of the Dwarven Resistance. I'll take them off your hands. Whatever you need. That belonged to one of the rebels, didn't it? I'll heat up the forge. Want something in particular? No need to thank me.
One of the mining rigs is here.
See the smoke above us? That's where we're headed. Let's see if we can't shut it down.
To explore here. Kind of nice to be out of Midgard for a bit, huh?
It's clinging to the wall! We gotta knock it down!
From above! Brother, that groom's found a perch on high.
Chock-a-block with materials that could help us. I'd grab whatever it spits up in the process.
The dwarves agreed to the deal with Asgard. Why do they blame you?
I talked them into their own exploitation.
They made their choice.
Work or die is not a choice. I only made it seem so. What you just picked up there is pure Svartalfheim ore. It won't be of use in the rig anymore, but perhaps our Huldra brothers could craft something from it. One less feathery spy.
Mimir, that big dwarf statue we saw. Who was he?
Alvi Stonefoot, Warden of Svartalfheim. He used his wisdom and might to imprison some of the most dangerous creatures in all the realm.
Is that pure Svartalfheim slag? Give it here! Whatever you need, I'll create. Huh. That might be my best piece yet today.
Very good.
Take care of your armor, and it'll take care of you.
How did these rigs come to be?
I had them built to harvest ore for armaments. Essentially harnessing resources that would otherwise go to the dwarves.
You think shutting these things down will help the dwarves become independent?
I don't know, but I have to try something.
Stories have you
Enough.
Told about?
We will continue later.
The key to that watchtower door should be on this island somewhere.
Papa!
Behind you! Look out!
The ground looks weak down here, Father. That gear looks like it would freeze. Maybe that lift can help us get higher. Might be easier to break that ground from up there.
Behind you! Incoming!
The key we're looking for. Now we must head to that watchtower on the shore.
What are you not saying?
I just need you to trust me.
Amir, what do you think it means? I've seen more raiders come back as Hellwalkers lately. I thought freeing the Valkyrie Queen was supposed to restore balance to the realms, and keep that from happening.
That's a good question, lad. And a troubling one. If Hell's filled up again, it suggests that something's been hindering Sigrun's efforts. Or perhaps something even more urgent is keeping her distracted and unable to visit. Even occasionally.
Yeah. Sorry, Amir. Back to Thorin Odin stories? Where were we? Okay. There was Thalmor, the stonemason.
Aye. He quarreled with his son. Went into the night to find him. Found Thor instead.
And there was Thalmor's son, Hrimthor.
Who built the walls of Asgard. Whispered something of importance. Freya before his betrayal and assassination.
There was Groa, of course.
The Knowledge Keeper and Prop. There's another mining rig on this island, brother. Smell that smoke.
Why would the dwarves agree to work for the Aesir in the first place?
That's the heart, eh?
You lied to them.
I lied to them.
Bet we could swing across that, lift thing.
Gantry.
Thanks. It's gotta be the right spot.
Those barrels. I smell fuel. Bet a spark from your blades would cause quite a boom.
Break through the ground here, if you found a high enough place to drop from.
Surprised the dwarves didn't shut these rigs off themselves.
One or two tried. The Einherjar made examples of them.
They killed the dwarves? Couldn't you have convinced them not to?
Aye.
Impressive.
That should help.
I don't think we can reach it there.
Yeah, that looks right. Wasn't so hard. Okay, Mimir?
To the blacksmiths of Svartalfheim, the creation of a weapon was a sacred thing. But Odin just wanted as many blades as he could get, as fast as he could get them. With every stolen resource and mediocre blade, the dwarves lost a bit of themselves.
Thank you.
survived because of you.
Ah, you're not wrong there, brother. Odin would have wiped out every last dwarf in Svartalfheim. If he couldn't use their skills, no one could.
Father, what's the biggest thing you've ever fought?
I do not know.
You can't remember?
Why do you ask?
I don't know. So we can compare?
It is not a competition.
I mean, not yet.
What is it, Mimir?
Ah, it's nothing, brother. Just... you ever have those moments where you wish you could... go back? Rewrite your own past. Make different decisions.
Journeying through time is more trouble than it is worth.
Ah, fair point. You're speaking metaphorically, right?
No.
Of course you're not.
So not all dwarves can do that thing Brock and Sindri do, right? Where they just walk between realms and turn up somewhere else?
Indeed, that's a rare skill. I gather one carefully cultivated by some secretive dwarven guild or other. Probably for the best. Them alone doing it is disconcerting enough.
Okay, what other terrible things have Odin and Thor done? I can't forget Ymir, the first giant.
Odin carved him up to form the realms from his body, and let the torrent of his blood nearly drown every giant alive.
What about the giants of Jotunheim? They all seemed dead when we finally made it there.
That remains a mystery. Well, admittedly, it sounds like the Aesir god's dream.
What about Fjorgyn? Thor's mother was a giant, wasn't she?
Indeed she was. The circumstances of her demise were murky at best, but not sure I can blame Odin for that one. He wasn't the same after.
Oh, I know. There was Skadi, the queen of the hunt.
Aye, she spurned Odin's affections, so he tricked her into killing her father.
There was Starkather the Mighty, the Jotnar military leader.
Slandered by Odin, tricked... and murdered by Thor. Ah, but enough of that for now.
Yeah, I don't think we can do anything with that yet. Father, look, we can chisel through this door.
Oh, glad to see that still works.
Nice.
Brother, you ever think of cooking meat with those blades of yours?
No. They would foul the meat.
Oh, because of the magic on them?
The blood.
Ah, yes. Carry on then.
Should we get back to listing all the awful deeds of the Aesir gods? And there was Thrym the Cunning, the giant king who stole Thor's hammer.
Odin traded him Freya to get it back. then sent Thor in disguise to murder his entire court.
Who else? Ah, Grungnir the Brawler, the stone giant.
Aye, mocked by Odin, murdered by Thor.
Enough of this.
But there's more.
I do not care. War with Odin is not the answer.
Oh, wow. It seems useful. Can you hear that?
No.
Thought I heard a voice.
Let's keep going, lad. Just put the key into that lock, brother. There. If you could give that drum a good loud strike.
That's the voice I heard.
I'd hoped it would have escaped by now, but we'll need to free it from its restraints.
I'm here for you.